Hello everybody and welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm. We've got the Massey Ferguson Park here and it's going to be used mainly for yard work. To be more specific, it's going to be down at Chantry Farm most of the time. And yes, there was a very good suggestion in the previous episode which said a good thing to do would be to put dual wheels on the Deutz Farm. And I think that is a good idea because it is one of our biggest tractors. We have two big tractors, which are these two here. The Case is 145 horsepower and the Deutz is 143 horsepower, so it is 2 horsepower less, but we might need the other tractor for something else, so we don't want to keep the dual wheels on it. You can take them off, but yeah, it's quite a big job, so if we keep one of them with duals, that'd be good, and I think the Deutz is the one for the job. Anyway, yes, before we do any of that, what we're going to do is take this back to the other yard, and ideally we need to do something with the field which we cut in the previous episode. Oh, the gate is open. Yes, we cut a field, a grass field. It wasn't a very big one. So I think we probably should just finish that off first of all, instead of moving on to the next job. Field number 23. But we could certainly do some harvesting or something. I don't know if we will do harvesting straight away, just because we have done quite a bit of it. But certainly very soon we're going to have to get the money in. Having said that, a lot of the money on this Let's Play is going to be coming from the animals. That is the plan. So we really do need to work on them quite well. But also we do need the money from the arable side to be able to afford new equipment for managing the animals with. So yeah, you do need both, certainly, for this Let's Play. Anyway, here we are, Chantry Farm. Just realised that I probably should have tilted the forks down. We were driving down the road with them like this, ready to spike somebody. Best place for this is probably just over here, unless we're going to use this tractor for windrowing. I think windrowing would be the job of choice today. If only we had one. It does help. Actually, what I might do is just go over there and see how easy it would be to bale as it is. So for 23, we'll have to go to 24 just to be able to get across. This is the gate here. Right, so I've done it fairly neatly, but it isn't going to be the easiest to bale. Having said that, it isn't a very big field, and buying a windrower just for this could be a bit extravagant. So I think, yes, we'll just bale it as it is, and we will get a bale wrapper to turn it into a silage bale. The reason why I want to get a silage wrapper is because silage bales are worth so much more than hay bales, so if we did sell any, we'd get a premium, a very big premium. So yes, let us jump into a tractor with enough horsepower, which probably isn't going to be this one. Let me just check. Sorry, sensitivity of the mouse keeps adjusting. 70 horsepower requirement. That's actually a lot less than I thought it would take. The Massey Ferguson is 105, so yes, we can use this today. Fantastic. There is the baler. There is the bale sell point. And we don't need the pallet fork on. So this is going to be a very quick job. We'll be doing a second job today as well. A job which I haven't yet decided. I suppose it could even be the wrapping. But we were supposed to be buying some sheep as well. So we won't be wrapping every bale. We need to keep some of the grass. Otherwise, they won't have any feed at all, which would be no good. I think this tractor, even though it says it can power this baler, it would be better on a larger tractor. It just doesn't look to scale somehow. I believe there is going to be an update for this map very soon to fix some of the issues. I don't think there's too many issues, but I have been told there is a bit of an issue with the silage pit at this yard. I don't know if it's true. But yeah, that's what I've been told. Plus, there's no traffic, which I'm guessing is being sorted out. So I'm hoping this is going to work. If it does work very well, we'll just, you know, blast through the job and get it done. But if we do have issues, then we'll likely have to wait until we have a windrower. But let's just see. It does help if you stay in line as well. The in-cab view I find much easier for this job. Now I did install the automatic unload mod for this baler, so I'm hoping it's going to work. Change the auto unload delay off. It needs to be set to about a second for it to work, I think. Hopefully this is going to work. But yeah, we won't get too many bales out of this. It's going to be fairly minimal. Here comes bale number one. At least with this field, they're not going to roll away. Ah, yes, fantastic. It does make it easier with it closing up and opening itself, but it is quite a lazy thing to do, I suppose. I could just press the button. It's more for big fields. If you had to do a huge field of straw or hay or grass or whatever, then yeah, pressing open and close all the time would probably get a bit tedious. But I'm assuming you have to do that in real life, unless it is automatic, I'm not too sure. Real farmers out there, you're needed. Can you set it to unload automatically, or do you have to do it yourself? I'd love to know. Right, bale number two. It's almost one every lap. Each headland. Is it going to be the exact same? It's pretty much the same place. Makes it easier to pick them up again. But I think this is working quite well. So I'm going to continue, and I will see you nearer to the end of this process. Actually, it does look quite neat when you look at it again. Although, yes, I won't try and compliment my work too much, because most of the time it isn't the best, but yeah, I think this field's alright. It looks alright. Yes, see you in a second. So there you go, that is another time lapse for you. I did say I was going to do some more, and well, there is the next one. I'm hoping to do some more in the future as well. Now, we've just got to finish off this bit over here, which was behind the gate. And then we will have finished. We're definitely not going to get another bale out of this, but next time we do some baling, obviously this will still be in there. so we'll be able to still use what we're picking up. It's not wasted. So how many bales did we get? 3, 6, 7. Okay. 7 bales. I think we'll do... Well, actually, the thing about it is 7 bales isn't very many bales at all. So buying a wrapper just for that seems a bit extravagant as well. So, thing to do, I don't know. Probably we shouldn't get the wrapper just yet. These could be our grass bales for the sheep. And I think actually the cows do require grass as well. They didn't used to, but they do now. Yes. In FS15, it wasn't grass, it was just turtle mix ration and straw and stuff like that, water. Anyway, another job completed. Gonna take this back to the yard and head over to the store with the Doisfar, and we're going to put some dual wheels on it. Looking forward to doing this. I think it will look quite good, and it's going to be for our cultivation work and also seeding. Obviously we can't afford a great big tractor just yet, but I'm hoping soon we'll be able to. We have to afford it. Now, where should we put this? In here? Something else I tend to forget is we actually have to pay for the sheep as well. They're not free. I'm just acting as if, oh yeah, we're just going to get given a load of sheep. But no. So we'll put this here. And then we're going to drive over to the store. Brilliant. Yes, one other thing. We're going to get a different vehicle. We're going to sell the pickup. It just doesn't suit the map at all. And I'm hoping to get a Land Rover. I don't know which one it's going to be just yet, but there will be a Land Rover, hopefully, on this map. I think it would fit really well. Am I really going to run all the way back to Coldborough Farm? I guess I am. It seems to be the way I'm going. Actually, the pickup is just up here, so we could jump into it and then drive to the yard and pick up the Doisfar and then take them both to the shop and obviously sell one and customise the other. Here we are. The Lizard Pickup Rodeo. You look fantastic on Goldcrest Valley, but not on Coldborough Farm. I'm sorry, it just has to be said. Can really get some speed up. We will be going much slower when we go to the store, as we've got this thing following us. I wonder if we should also update our cultivator or seeder. Thing is, it's money. The money is always hard. So, maybe not just yet. I can't rush stuff. This is my problem. I always want to upgrade stuff straight away when we actually can't afford it. And that is when the farm fails. So I think, yeah, with Coldborough Farm, I'm going to be more sensible. And we're just going to get stuff we actually need. Obviously, it would be very nice to have a new cultivator and seeder, but we have one. And at this stage, we need to focus on the livestock. Are you following? Good. Has he got the chunky wheels on? They're not the standard wheels, are they? I don't think they are. So, in theory, we should be able to keep those, and we'll be able to swap between those and the dual wheels. I don't know how much they're going to cost, hopefully not too much. Again, the dual wheels probably aren't a necessity, but yes, it will help with compaction and stuff. Of course, we don't need to look out for any traffic at this stage. Here we are at the store. So I've actually forgotten which fields we own. Ah, field number 22, that's a grass field. Field number 9, 2, 8, 7, and 4. And 23. So, quite a lot of stuff actually. We have a lot of fields. One thing's for sure, we don't need to be focusing on buying any more land. Not at this stage. Right, you need to go in the customising box. Pretty sure these are the chunky wheels. They do look really big. Customise. Yes, wide tyres, standard tyres. Oh no, they are the standard tyres. Wow. Rear twin wheels. Narrow tyres, wide tyres. Okay, we're going to go with that then. It is £800, but then we have, by the look of it, £1,000. We must have to pay the mechanic to do this. £200 goes to the mechanic. That is a bit of a rip-off, to be fair. That's very expensive. Still, we're £1,000 down, but we have now a tractor with dual wheels, which looks really amazing. Let me just go in the garage again, just to see what we do own. Yes, these things are going to have to be upgraded, but when we are a bit better in a financial position. So where we need to go to is the livestock market, and that is behind me by the look of it. I think it is through here. Hello, everybody? Anybody in? This is where we buy the sheep. Oh, bit of basketball. Whenever I see this, I'm always so tempted. Even though, in real life, I'm not sporty at all. I did it. So, yeah, it's a bit noisy here. But still, let's buy some sheep. We will buy 15. And obviously we've had to pay for them to be delivered to the farm. Because we don't own the livestock trailer. Another thing which we'll have to get in the future. Ooh, so wide. I think we'd have to have an escort. We must be taking up pretty much the entire road. To be fair, I've never seen this tractor with dual wheels before. And it actually suits them. When we get back up to the top, I'm going to check the state of every field and see what they're actually up to. And if there's anything which is ready, then I might consider starting a harvest. However, I am very cautious that the sheep do need to be tended to, so we can't just leave them as we've now bought them. Oh, it's a good sound. We still haven't been to Yatton Ridge Farm. That is the pig farm. So I haven't actually seen if anything's changed there. We will be getting some pigs. Pigs are a great thing to get early on because they can reproduce really fast. However, I've gone with the sheep first of all because they don't need a great deal of maintenance. I think it is just grass and water, so they're very simple. We now have the grass, which we should be able to just give to them as a bale. And obviously the water, I don't think we have it, do we? Can't remember. I've done like one episode on here and I've already forgotten if we have a water bowser. Pretty sure we don't, because I've just checked the garage, so I don't think there was one there. The only reason I've come here in this tractor is so I didn't have to teleport. Really don't like teleporting. I probably should have actually bought a tanker back with that. That would have been easier. But first things first, let's get a bale. We do need to give them some grass. And I don't think we have to shred the bale. I'm not really with it today. Hopefully I'll be a bit better in the next episode. Not thinking straight. Plus, I would like to make these episodes a bit longer as well. Because I think longer episodes, in a way, are better. I'm sort of for and against them. I'm against them in the fact that a lot of people don't have time to sit through, for example, a 45-minute video. But then I think it's better for immersion, because if you get into it, then every time it stops, because it's the end of the episode, it can sort of spoil the immersion which is there. So, yeah, like I say, I'm for and against it. Right, so I'm just going to pick one up. It is a pallet fork, I am aware of that, but I don't think we have a bale spike at this stage. a pallet fork does work fine anyway, so we might as well use it. But here we are in the field. I think we'll try and get two if we can. It just depends if they're going to fit on the forks. I don't know if two will. All we can do is try it. Number one, and finally number two. I'll try and make it look good. I'll square up with it. Never looks good if you've got them all over the place. It's an angle. So far, things aren't really going to plan. Should have put it next to it. Right. I have totally rotated the bale, but at least we have two next to each other. So, in theory, if that doesn't get stuck... Yes, look at that. It always looks better if they're on the spikes properly. So what we're going to do is head back to the yard, give it to the sheep, and then we'll focus on the water. Feeling very front heavy. But at least it doesn't do those crazy things which happen in Farming Simulator 15, where you could pretty much flip a tractor over forwards with the smallest bale you could find. It's much better, the weight of these bales. So is it just here you put them? It is. Oh, crazy bale. Oops. Well, that didn't really go to plan. I'll fish that out of there. 1 second. Here are the sheep, munching away. So yes, that is actually their bale, so there's not really much point in taking it out. When this trough is empty, when the supply is depleted, this bale should fill it up, hopefully. If it doesn't work, I will fish it out later, but they should be okay with it. It's just the plastic wrap, which is a bit of an issue. They're clever sheep. They know not to eat it. Come on, sheep. Your feed is ready. Well done, you clever thing. Here comes another one. You're coming, that one's coming as well. And this one here, oh, everybody's coming, there's a stampede. Better get out of the way. Just water. Yes, they have no water at all. Why am I sitting in their trough? One thing for sure, it's upset them. The stampede is going the other way. Right. Crazy farming game's over. Let us go over to the store once again and buy a water Bowser. I really should have brought it back with the Deutz Fahr. Wasn't thinking. But I can go over there again with this and we'll bring it back. If we had the Land Rover, I could just attach it to that and bring it over really fast. It is going to set us back a little bit, but I think we're doing okay, really. It was mainly because we sold the pickup. That's the reason we have £31,000. And of course, yes, buying the next vehicle is going to be a bit of an expense. I'm hoping it's not going to be too expensive. Maybe in the region of £6,000 for a used Land Rover. Quite an old one, hopefully. I know they can be expensive. And the water Bowser itself, how much is that? I don't think it was much. I will check before we get there though, just to make sure I haven't already bought it. No, I haven't. Good. Oh, whoa, £9,500 for it. That is expensive. But it is new, so yes, you would expect that kind of price. Ah, the Joskin Water Bowser. Filling it up used to be at the main yard and over at the store, just on the other side of the road, the sell point, I should say. So I'm guessing it is the same place. I've already seen the water fill point at the yard, so I know there's one there. There could even be one over at Chantry Farm, but to play it safe, we'll fill this up here. It used to be around the back, but it could be this tanker here. Well, this tank, I should say, not tanker. Could be fertiliser. I think it is. So maybe it is further round. Yes, here it is. Brilliant. So yes, it is costing us money. But again, there is no water source on this map, so we can't just steal it from a river. We're going to have to pay for good tap water. At least it's fresh. We're full. Back to Chantry Farm to give the sheep their water. And then it should be them done. This is what I like about the sheep. They really don't require much work. But at the same time, yes, their pallet stack takes a very long time to fill. So when you get money out of them, you get a lot. But getting money out of them is pretty hard. These sheep, they're so tight. Oh, they don't give much out. But no, seriously, when you do sell a pallet, you get a lot of money. Especially if you time it when there is a great demand on, you get a lot. It's like, what is it, about £8,000 or something for a pallet. It's incredible. Oh, and we are playing on easy as well, so that will help. Some people did notice this before. There is a reason behind it. It's because this is such a huge map, and obviously a lot of equipment is required to do this as a Let's Play, which I haven't bought. So instead of starting off with the equipment we need, I've decided to start on easy, so we can still sort of bring in a lot of income fast to be able to buy them ourselves. So it's just a different way of playing it, really. And in a way, I think it's actually cheating less than if we started off with everything. It's better this way. If you've played on hard before, you will know that it is very hard. It is seriously tough to make money. So if I did that as a Let's Play, which I have done before, we just don't get very far. So it's not really worth it. Here we go, sheep. We are coming with your water. Hope they appreciate this. Now we've left their pen, they've all gone and swarmed in on the food. Understandable. Right, better not crash. Oh, too far away. Don't want to crash into that pillar. There we go. So there you go, sheep. This one here is stunned. It's seen a tractor. What is that? Or maybe it's the driver. Certainly upset it anyway. What I'll do is I'll check the chart. Oh, look at that. That is so good. Everything is, well, everything is 100%, if it could be. These are full, and this is 100%. We just need to keep on top of the cleaning, because as we know, they're very mucky. But not as mucky as the pigs, they're terrible. We'll put the tanker over here, and then I'm hoping to work on either the cows or the sheep, or both, next time. When it may well be a much longer video. In fact, what I'll do is I'll put a poll in this video to see what everybody else thinks. Shall we have this series as longer episodes? So when I say longer, I mean 30 to 45 minutes, not 2 hours, because that would be very long and it would probably get boring. So yes, please vote. Do you want longer episodes? Yes or no? It's up to you. Right, so there we go. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. And until next time, see you again soon. Bye for now. We might as well use it. But, oh, crikey, I didn't see that thing there. Wow.